put up for Hayes before the law enforcement officer from Canada made his way out to the arena. Son loading up the shock stick, putting new batteries in there. So that weapon is really charged up for this match.
I don't think that's unusual, quite honestly, Sean. I think he loads new batteries in every time he comes into the ring. But who does he test them on to make sure they're functioning?
I think it doesn't really matter anybody who happens to be in the vicinity when he gets it all charged up. He zaps them. Two unlucky members of the ring crew have fallen victim to Mountie's shot stick.
Yes, I believe they have, actually. You're quite right there. Virgil, however, is undaunted by all that shock stick treatment that the Mountie keeps bragging about, all the rights that he reads to people, and even less is he concerned about the wrestling ability of the Mountie as he looks around very confident.
What up, Barry? Did you notice that T-shirt? I haven't seen the Virgil T-shirt.
No, I haven't either. You're right.
Sure, it's quickly become a very popular item. He is definitely one of the most popular superstars in the WWF today.
Well, Sean, I like his T-shirt. It's very, very nice. But I can't imagine you wearing those tights that he's wearing. Or do you have a pair of
those? I think you may be right, Lord Alfred Hayes. I think that would be a bit of a stretch for me.
Yes.
Well, Mountie and Virgil go at it here. They lock up. Referee wants to see a break. Green's in Virgil's face. I am Mountie. I think that is very clear. Virgil. Let him get away with that.
I'm surprised too.
No reaction at all.
He was probably a little shaken up there by the halitosis of the Mountie. Screaming and shouting like that right in his face.
His bad breath too. Once again, he's superstar sizing the other up. And a break direct rewind. This time, Virgil thinking about it.
Oh, my God!
I like Virgil. He's really a good fellow. Look at that.
They're even now.
Are you fighting?
Yes, they are. Absolutely even. One on one then. Fancy footwork.
A lot of verbal warfare going on out there, Lord Alfred Hayes. Mountie duped into that big swing there. Sonic drop nearly sends him out of the ring. He went over the top rope, but he held on.
Oh, a nice athletic maneuver there performed by the Mountie. I'm very, very surprised.
Virgil turns just in time. Jimmy Hunt did not do his job distracting Virgil long enough. And again, the Mountie on the losing end.
Sean, would you say that Virgil was sacked up for this particular encounter?
I'll say it.
Boy,
this is where the Mountie is heading back to the locker room, but I'm sure Jimmy Hart is trying to explain to him, look, if you go back there, you don't get any money.
Absolutely.
I won't get my 80% cut.
Look at that. He's taking back his ring. Good old Jimmy Hart.
Didn't know I read lips, did you?
No, I didn't know that.
About that whole conversation.
Good for you. Virgil is cock-a-hoo with his initial success here, but he's got to watch the Mountie very, very closely indeed, because he really is a devious fellow. There's not many that are more devious than the Mountie. Virgil looked in complete, absolute 100% physical condition.
Right on his feet, but he could not stop that boot despite those incredible abdominal muscles. And we have yet to see Virgil go to work with his fist. He's definitely one of the most gifted pugilists here in the WWF, Lord Alfred Hayes.
Yes, indeed. I think he took a little bite out of the ear there.
Did not like the taste of the Mountie either. That headlock.
Our referee here, Hebner, is going to have a difficult job controlling this match by the looks of things. Some desperation moves by both men so far.
Virgil sent into the ropes. Leapfrog by the Mountie. time, waiting for Virgil to come back. All that comes back is his boot right to the head of the Mountie. Oh, a little consoling at ringside.
There's a great deal of opposites in what the Mountie does. He shows great athleticism in some of his moves. And then the next moment, he's very sluggish and very lazy and sort of lackadaisical and gets caught. I don't really understand that at all. Can you explain that to me, Sean?
Well, I just think that it is something that he's very gifted at. And through his numerous encounters, become one of his skills, that I believe.
Yes, I would imagine that he's a... If he finds everything and puts it all together at the same time, he's a very, very...
dangerous elbow.
Look at that move, for example. That was absolutely brilliant. And not really locking that leg in, a sloppy cover.
That was close, though. Virgil, obviously stunned, barely reacted in time.
Well, the Mountie overestimated what he'd done to him. He really thought he had him there, could cover him, and nothing would happen. Virgil, he certainly has a lot of resolve.
Now, Virgil dumped across the top rope and then just kicked right off the top rope there. Landed hard on the arena floor. His feet barely broke his fall.
Oh, bad fall down by Virgil.
Mountie quite proud of himself.
He's knocked the all the wind out of him, and he's trying to get that back again, but he should take his time. Well, obviously he's a little stunned, a little fuzzy upstairs.
That shot hit Virgil right behind the ear.
He can't seem to brush the cobwebs away, and the Mountie now is mounting a much, much harder and more forceful attack. What he wants.
Virgil turns it around, literally. As the back of the head of the Mountie is bounced off the canvas. Jimmy is parked in a very dangerous area. He's waving at Traxxas, hoping to get it to the Mountie so he can use it. And there's a thought, but Dave Hefner is keeping a very close eye on the Mountie to stop.
He is indeed. And the Mountie made another awful mistake a little while ago in the ring. Seems to be paying for it now, dearly. And Virgil has given him fresh life, more encouragement, a lot more incentive to go after his man.
To the ropes. Well, step to that backdrop. Not a lot of height, but certainly slammed the Mountie to the canvas.
And look at the Mountie. His head is wobbling. He's practically out on his feet.
Got the million-dollar dream locked in. Jimmy Hart going crazy at ringside. And Virgil would have stayed with the hold, allowing Jimmy Hart to get to him.
And he's left the million-dollar dream on there. Wow.
The Mountie has a shot stick. Jimmy Hart, before he was... serious trouble, threw the stick into the ring, and the Mountie got a hold of it.
And I do believe the referee saw that. I couldn't be absolutely positive, but well, I don't know. He might have disqualified.
Well, we're going to get the official word, Lord Alfred Hayes. It looks as though that's the way it's going to end up, though. I'd say, Lord Alfred Hayes, either way, he was going to lose this encounter. Jimmy Hart came to his aid, and this matchup had a shocking conclusion, and not quite sure what shape Virgil's in.